Good morning, all of you. As per the introduction, I am Harsh, the co-founder and CEO of Blue Planet Skills. So agenda for the session given to me was the prototype validation. And coming to the point, I have divided this overall session into four major parts. To begin with, what is what? In terms of prototype validation, why the prototype validation is required, how the prototype validation should be done. And I have tried to keep a small open house, how your team would be able to arrange this they need to check. And it would be a short and crisp session in terms of you people understanding the overall startup journey. So to begin with, this is a small introduction about what we have co-founded. Blue Planet as a group is headquartered at Singapore. We have 13 companies in UK, Singapore, Malaysia, Vietnam, India. We are primarily into waste management, and companies like SBI Neev, OSK Malaysia, Namura have invested into us. And in the same time, we are also engaged with Niti Aayog for community level interventions from the side of green sector and waste management. So typically speaking, one of the most important sectors of the new era, an underlooked sector also, so we are serving that. Now coming to the session. So as I was told today that I have to talk about prototype validation. So I have made all these discussions with the assumption that ideation and the concept part, the learners who are sitting here are very, very much known about these two parts of the startup process, which is ideation and the concept. And that is why I'm speaking about the prototype validation. So please forgive me if my assumption is wrong, but as the topic itself says, so I have put emphasis only and only on the prototype validation and not on ideation and concept, right? So to begin with, a very, very basic definition of prototyping. So a prototype is nothing but a tool to help you to validate specific assumptions. When I talk about any journey of a startup or something, to begin with, there is a problem and you offer a solution in a different way, which can be which can be different from either your competitor or a new way altogether. So when you assume something in the real life, taking a U-turn becomes lot much tougher. When I talk about tougher, I'm not saying that it will not happen. Just take an example of expressway in Noida. If you are able to take one, if you will miss one turn, then I think another turn will come in another 10, 12, 14 kilometers. So what you are losing is in this example is both time and fuel. And when I talk about fuel, I talk about money. So that is why in any startup process, prototype becomes much, much important, because you are losing two important aspects of your life, which is time and which is money. So though, believe me, when you talk to at least 100 of the people who have started any sort of business, the prototyping is the most neglected part of their journey. What we feel, we try to always do one thing, which is we try to run the show and we try to that whatever will come in between, we will solve. But my experience as an entrepreneur is the more you will put efforts in the training room, the less you will bleed on the ground. In the same way, the prototyping aspect is very much similar, right? The point is to present user with a situation where they can experience product or service as if it is already existing. So I believe my target audience today is what? Maybe a graduate or postgraduate students who may or may not come into the arena of starting their own venture. But try to understand one thing. Whenever you do your summer internship or whenever you do your winter projects or capstone projects, you try to only, why you do that? You do that with the reason that at least I can get a glimpse of what I will be getting in my future life. In the same way, if you are providing a product or a service, and if you will keep that idea validating from somebody, then you will not fall apart. Are you understanding? That there would you it, there would not be a blunder from your side. Ki boss, you know, I was mujhe jana to Delhi tha aur maine ticket Mumbai ka le liya. It will not happen like that. So this is what a brief introduction is, why, what is prototype and how it is made. In the same way, if I will go to my next slide, see, these are few pictures. A scalable model on the left, then a 3D image on the right, and then a pen and pencil image below that. So these are nothing but the prototyping. So the easiest way to prototype is this one, what you can see in the screen, cafe. So the best you can do is you can put your idea on a piece of paper, you can discuss it with somebody. Then when you can see 3D images which are coming up, then you can say a scalable model where you see in lot of builders try to make these models so that you are able to perceive what you are buying. So prototypes helps you or your customers. It helps you to engage with your customers, and so that they may be having a correct look and feel what your product will look like, right? So this is from where the prototype session starts. And yes, I have specifically put this slide with a reason that there is always a confusion among the student between prototype and MVP. So even if you are new to this startup journey, MVP is minimum viable product. So there is a difference between MVP and prototyping. Prototyping comes much, much ahead than MVP. So when I talk about MVP, I talk about that the product is functional and it is viable also, as compared to prototype, where the product is even not functional and even not viable. So I can give, मैं अगर आपको ये समझाना चाहूँ तो मैं आपको ये समझा सकता हूँ एक मोबाइल ऐप के एग्जाम्पल के साथ. अगर आप किसी मोबाइल ऐप का मॉकअप बनवाते हो, मॉकअप मीन्स एक डिजाइन बनवाते हो डिजाइनर से कि मेरा स्क्रीन ऐसा लगेगा, फीचर्स ऐसे होंगे, ये बटन दबाने पे ऐसा स्क्रीन हो जाएगा, राइट? तो वो एक प्रोटोटाइप है. बट उसी को जब आप किसी टेक टीम को दे देते हो या अपनी इंटरनल टीम को दे देते हो कि भाई इसमें जो है इसको फंक्शनल बना दो, अगर टोटल 20 फंक्शन है तो चलो तुम अभी 5 फंक्शन डाल करके बना दो, लेकिन ये फंक्शनल होना चाहिए. तो और दूसरा इंपॉर्टेंट बात है, वाइबल होना चाहिए. वाइबल होने का मतलब क्या कहना चाहता हूं मैं, कि ऐसा नहीं है कि मेरा ऐप जो बन के तैयार हो रहा होगा वो हो रहा होगा $2 million में या $1 million में, राइट। बट प्रोटोटाइप क्योंकि पेपर पे बन रहा होता है, 3D इमेज में बन रहा होता है, तो वहां पे ये दो इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट्स दिमाग में नहीं लाए जाते हैं। और आप सबको एक इम्पॉर्टेंट नोट में बता दूं कि प्रोटोटाइप बनाते वक्त ये बिल्कुल भी दिमाग में आपको नहीं रखना चाहिए कि ये मेरा फाइनल प्रोडक्ट होगा। फाइनल प्रोडक्ट और प्रोटोटाइप के बीच में बहुत ढेर सारा डिस्टेंस हो सकता है। ये हमारे साथ भी हुआ है, ये बहुत स्टार्टअप्स के साथ हुआ है कि हमने आइडिएशन स्टेज पे ऑल टुगेदर कुछ और सोचा था, प्रोटोटाइपिंग में निकल के कुछ और आया और फाइनल प्रोडक्ट बिल्कुल ही डिफरेंट था। सो आई होप आई एम एबल टू मेक माय पॉइंट क्लियर कि जो प्रोटोटाइप है वो प्रोटोटाइप आपको बिल्कुल भी ऐसा नहीं है, मतलब आप ऐसे समझो बहुत बेसिक भाषा में कि आपको बहुत सारी गलतियां करने का मौका जो है वो प्रोटोटाइप स्टेज में मिल जाता है। एज कंपेयर टू जब तक कि आप MVP पे पहुंचते हो। तो गोइंग टू माय नेक्स्ट स्लाइड, अगेन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट है व्हाई यू हैव जॉइंड दिस सेशन और व्हाई दिस सेशन हैज बीन कंडक्टेड एंड why we are putting so much efforts. So first important point is, as I told you, to engage with the clients. To engage with the client is literally what you are doing. If you have a startup journey, so you have conceded an idea, like what do you say, if I give you a very small example, like an ola cab or a uber cab. Okay, so like a ola cab or a uber cab, so what a prototype will help you, even on the piece of paper, when you will go with your idea to talk to anybody, any customer or something, ki sir main ek aisi app banana chahta hu जो आप जहां पर भी खड़े होंगे वहां पर आपको कैब मिल जाएगी और आपके डेस्टिनेशन तक छोड़ देगी। ये ऐसा फीचर है, इसमें ये एडवांटेजेस हैं इसके, ड्राइवर को एम्प्लॉयमेंट मिलेगा, ब्ला 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 ब्ला। तो आपको जो आपका कस्टमर है या स्टेक होल्डर भी बोल सकते हैं, स्टेक होल्डर्स कैन बी इन्वेस्टर्स ऑल्सो, सो इट विल गिव यू अ फेयर एंगेजमेंट विद दोज क्लाइंट्स एंड स्टेक होल्डर्स। And in between this, you will get a very, very fair idea of whatever you are thinking, whether you are going on the right track or not. In continuation to that, the second point of why to validate is gain clarity. So what I have written there, if you can see on my screen, it is making gray a bit colorful. So why I want to say this? Because whenever you are a part of a journey, no, it's there is lot of uncertainty whether my product would be accepted, whether I would be able to pass my idea, or lot many clarities. So prototyping helps you to get lot of clarity also. When you take your idea to your professors, to your colleagues, to your probable customers, so your gray starts becoming colorful, right? In the if I talk about the third part, it is identifying the red flags. And when I talk about identifying the red flags, I am talking about what we do in the minefield. Like, for example, you have taken an idea which is the best suited idea in the classroom. But when you take this idea outside your classroom, there is no buyer for that idea. So suppose if you have not done a proper prototyping and you went out taking this idea, so you will be losing lot much of money and time also. Fourth important aspect is understanding the variations. It is AB theory in my language. when I talk about variations, so if there is an app which has a two different purpose to serve, that means it serves something to retail clients also, and at the same time it serves something to the corporate clients also. So in prototyping, understanding variations becomes lot easier as compared to in the real product. Optimize cost and launch faster. Because I'm again saying, when I took the example of Greater Noida Expressway and you taking the wrong turn, again, it will save you a lot of cost and it will help you to come into the market earlier. And last, why you should validate is creative view. So this is where an entrepreneur actually comes into the picture, helps you to find a new you. So what happens if any of your colleagues is into this startup journey or want to do a startup journey? Believe me, this journey is very tough, very what do you say, it takes lot of time, it takes lots of energy, it takes lot many things to become an entrepreneur. But the creative side of you, right? Mera app aisa dikhna chahiye, usme aisa color hona chahiye, aise feature hone chahiye, mera product aisa dikhna chahiye, jo main product de raha hoon uska packaging aisa hona chahiye, right? Usually हम बात करते हैं पैकेजिंग इस कलर का हो, इसमें रिबन लग के मैं दूंगा, ये वो बहुत सारी बातें हैं. सो इट प्रोटोटाइपिंग हेल्प्स यू टू ब्रिंग दैट क्रिएटिव साइड ऑफ यू कम इनटू द पिक्चर. सो आई होप बिकॉज इट इज इट वुड बी अ मोनोलॉग सॉर्ट ऑफ अ सेशन, सो इफ आई एम मेकिंग सेंस, बिकॉज व्हाई वैलिडेटिंग इज, if you are able to perceive why it is important, then only you will be able to buy how you should validate. So I'm again repeating my points. It is number one to engage with clients, number two to gain clarity, number three identifying the red flags, number four understanding variations, number five optimizing cost and launch faster, and number six creative view. So moving ahead, ways to validate. Again, very important part of my session, in which what is happening that I have understood prototyping hoti kya hai. Main ye bhi samajh gaya hoon ki prototype kyun karni chahiye. Ab ye important, sabse important baat hai, prototype karni kaise chahiye. Right. So there are few points which I have written here. There can be many others also, but few important points I have written here. So first is not prototyping at all. When I say not prototyping at all, it is also a type of a prototyping. How? Suppose if you are if your startup is into a field which is already present. If I say example of Ola, when Uber was already there, so there is not much, what do you say, new or much unseen thing which you need to show to your customer. What you have to do, you just have to go to somebody, take the example of Uber, ki sir main Uber jaisi ek ride hailing app banana chahta hu. उसके दिमाग में सब कुछ आ जाएगा कि हाँ ये ऐप ऐसी होगी, ऐसा होगा, ऐसा होगा, ऐसा होगा. तो वहां पे आपको प्रोटोटाइप मेरे हिसाब से करने का जरूरत ही नहीं है. तो एक इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ये आ जाता है कि अगर आपका कोई एग्जिस्टिंग प्रोडक्ट या सर्विस है जिसको या तो आप किसी नई ज्योग्राफी में लेके जा रहे हैं, जस्ट फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई एम टेलिंग कि मानो साउथ अफ्रीका में ऊबर नहीं चलती है, तो आप साउथ अफ्रीका में कोई न्यू टेरिटरी में जाना चाहते हैं, तो वहां पर आपने बोला कि दीज आदि फीचर्स और मैं इस पे काम करना चाहता हूं, वो एंट्रिंग इनटू न्यू मार्केट, गेटिंग इनटू प्राइस वॉर, इन सब जगहों पे अगर आप प्रोटोटाइपिंग नहीं भी कर रहे हैं तो आपका काम चल जाएगा। बट ये सर्विसेज एग्जिस्टिंग मार्केट में प्रिवेल होनी चाहिए, और दूसरा कस्टमर को उस सर्विस के बारे में अंदाजा होना चाहिए। ये दो इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट है। दूसरा इंपॉर्टेंट इज स्टार्ट प्री सेलिंग। जब मैं प्री सेलिंग की बात करता हूं तो आप देखोगे ये जो सो कॉल्ड मार्वल एवेंजर्स की जितनी भी मूवीज होती हैं, वो छोटा सा एक ट्रेलर बनाते हैं और उसके बाद एक मतलब कहीं कहीं पे तो शायद 20 दिन पहले 25 दिन पहले से प्री बुकिंग करनी शुरू कर देते हैं, राइट? सो अब तो आपने देखा होगा कि मूवी के सेकेंड पार्ट का टीजर शायद एक साल पहले ही आ जाता है, मतलब मूवी बनी भी नहीं होती है सेकेंड पार्ट और उसका टीजर रिलीज हो जाता है। तो इट यू कैन ट्रीट एज अ लाइव एग्जांपल ऑफ प्री सेलिंग प्रोटोटाइपिंग, कि छोटा सा आपने मे बी एक वीडियो टीजर तैयार कर दिया या कुछ भी तैयार कर दिया, और उसके बहाने से आप कस्टमर के पास पहुंचे कि क्या वो इस पे पैसे लगाने को तैयार है कि नहीं तैयार है। आई होप आई एम एबल टू गिव यू सम इनसाइट इनटू इट। सेकंड इज फेक एड। डोंट टेक द वर्ल्ड एज फेक। व्हाट आई वांट टू से हियर इज इफ यू आर अ टेकी, इफ यू आर अ बीटेक गाय और समबडी, और इफ यू आर इवन अ मैनेजमेंट स्टूडेंट, यू हैव अ tech friend with you, you just try to create a web page and try to create a sign up page in that. So, and you say that, for example, you say that we will be teaching you coding for free, और वहां पे sign up लगा दो, और आपने coding के अपने features, classroom के features, कैसे पढ़ाओगे क्या नहीं पढ़ाओगे उसमें आपने website पे डाल दिया। If that website is able to attract people, if people are signing up that website, so you can have a fair idea ki boss, my idea is being bought by people, and it will just give you a good sense of feeling ki I'm going on the right track, and it is again very cheap. For a BTech student, making a web page today cost, I believe, negligible, right? So this is another
it's
way.
11 o'clock.
This is another way to validate. Fourth way to validate is printing brochures or digital copy. I will suggest that don't put your company's name into it, but again, you can do that. See, why I am asking you or why I am giving you these ways are only given to you to check what the end consumer of your product feel about that product. So just like a digital just like a video teaser which I was telling you, in the same way a digital or a print copy of a brochure will work. You what you do, you try to get a brochure printed or a digital copy of a printed with the details put into that brochure, and you can put a line that if you are interested, click on this button, right? Or if it is a physical brochure, then you can say connect to us on this number. So, and if you are testing it in a closed circle or a circumference, then again it will help you to check how much my product is getting attracted or catching the customer's eye, right? So again, important activity you can do as part of the prototyping exercise. Fifth point is product box. When I talk about product box, I am talking about, for example, if you have a marketing professor, he will tell you this, that if you have a product or a service, if you have a product, then you do, what do? You try to make a good good attractive box of it, writing all the features into the box, everything, and there might not be a product in it. So need not to worry. You put it into a shelf of a mall or a place where customer can see and check that box and understand how much they are attracted towards that box or whatever is written in that box. So what will help you in this? It will help you to check about, number one, the look and feel of the box. Number two, the information which you have given in the box, how much the customer is getting attracted to it. You stay nearby the box, and if somebody comes close to that box or something, so you can easily say to him or her that we want to check the packaging or the feature of the box. So we were doing this prototyping. So I hope you are understanding what I want to say, that if you are making a very good product in terms of where the packaging is more important. So you can do this activity, it will help you. And the sixth is mock-ups. This is very well used these days. I took the example also, and even in my journey, I have used mock-ups several times, because it is the most cheapest way to get your idea understandable by your end consumer or end your investor. बहुत ज़्यादा पैसा भी नहीं लगता है, बहुत ज़्यादा clarity भी आपको भी मिल जाती है और आपके साथ साथ आपके consumer को भी मिल जाती है और investor को भी मिल जाती है. So mock-up, you need some designer, or if you have that designing knack, you can also make that mock-ups. Continuing to how you can prototype, another example is paper or digital prototype. सबसे आसान सस्ता क्लासरूम में बैठ करके घर पे बैठ करके जो प्रोटोटाइप होता है वो पेपर प्रोटोटाइप होता है. अपने हाथों से आर्ट बना करके, एरो बना करके, अंडरलाइन करके आप किसी को भी समझा सकते हैं कि मैं करना क्या चाहता हूँ. करेक्ट. सो द बेस्ट एंड द मोस्ट इजीएस्ट वे टू प्रोटोटाइप इज पेपर प्रोटोटाइप. एंड हम करते भी हैं ये, हमें वर्ल्ड भले ना पता होता हो लेकिन हम ये करते भी हैं. अक्सर एक पेपर पे अपना आइडिया बनाते हैं, लिखते हैं और वो किसी बाजू वाले को दिखाते हैं कि सी व्हाट आई वांट टू डू दिस, हाउ इट वुड बी, कैसा लगेगा, समथिंग 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 समथिंग. सो पेपर प्रोटोटाइपिंग इज वेरी मच प्रेवलेंट. और जो सबसे पहला स्लाइड, अगर मैं वापस जा पाऊँ, दिस एक्सट्रीम राइट बिलो, दिस इज पेपर प्रोटोटाइपिंग, कि मैंने अपने हाथ से ही बना दिया कि बॉस पहले मैं ये, फिर ऐसे फ्लो जाएगा. प्रोटोटाइप खुद के साथ साथ सामने वाले को समझा पा रहा है कि आखिर मैं करना क्या चाहता हूँ. सबसे सस्ता, सबसे चीप और इफेक्टिव भी है. अगेन इफ यू टॉक अबाउट वन मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन in the any startup journey of product or services, how to define a price. It becomes very, very tough call. So whether your product is underpriced or your product is overpriced, underprice kar denge, profitability khatam ho jayegi, overprice kar denge, customer hi nahi aayega. So how much to put the exact price becomes a very, very इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फॉर एनी एंटरप्रेन्योर. सो एक उसका छोटा सा सॉल्यूशन है, और हम ये प्रैक्टिकल लाइफ में करते भी हैं. बस बुक में जब हम पढ़ रहे हैं इसको तो इस तरीके से पढ़ रहे हैं. अदरवाइज व्हाट वी डू, वी ट्राई टू मेक अ सर्विस विद अ कॉम्पिटिटर्स. इफ देयर इज अ कॉम्पिटिटर देन द कॉम्पिटिटर प्राइस वुड बी देयर एंड, बट इफ देयर इज नो कॉम्पिटिटर and in your mind if you have thought that the service is of rupees 100, you start giving that service from rupees 60 or rupees 50, and to every new consumer if that consumer is not coming in bulk, you keep on raising the prices to find the resistance. Jaise, for example, if you talk about a bottle of Coke, if the MRP is not giving there, if you are prototyping that Coke, what you are doing, you are first selling it at 10 rupee. कस्टमर को बहुत वाव लग रहा है कि हाँ बहुत बढ़िया है, बहुत सस्ता है. उसके बाद 12 रुपये, उसके बाद 14 रुपये, उसके बाद 16 रुपये, फिर 20 रुपये, फिर 22 रुपये, फिर 25 रुपये, और धीमे 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 आपको दिखेगा कि रेजिस्टेंस आने लगा है. और जब आपको रेजिस्टेंस आने लगेगा तो आपको ये समझ में आ जाएगा मेरे प्रोडक्ट का इतना प्राइस लगभग ठीक है. अब यहाँ पे इतना आसान नहीं है. आपका पॉपुलेशन साइज क्या है, आपका सैंपल साइज क्या है, आपने किस जगह पर ये कोक अपना बेचा है, राइट? पता लगा 40 डिग्री का टेम्परेचर था और दूर दूर तक कोई कोक वाला था ही नहीं, तो आपने 40 रुपए का भी बेच दिया तो आदमी ने ले लिया. बट इट्स अ आउटलायर, राइट? व्हेन आई टॉक अबाउट आउटलायर, इट विल हैपन ओनली वंस और ट्वाइस. But in a normal scenario, or when you have put this coke at 10 different places, और वहां पे जहां पे प्राइस में आपको कस्टमर को apprehension आने लगे, वहां से आप प्राइस, perceived प्राइस प्रोडक्ट का निकाल सकते हैं. तो द राइट वर्ड वुड बी द perceived प्राइस. अब हो सकता है आपकी प्रोडक्ट कॉस्टिंग 100 रुपए की हो, बट अगर प्रोडक्ट का perceived प्राइस ही 40 रुपए है, तो आपने मतलब कहीं ना कहीं कुछ ना कुछ गलती करी है अपनी प्राइसिंग मेथोडोलॉजी में, राइट? सो आई होप आई एम क्लियर विद दिस राइज इन द प्राइस. सो लैंडिंग पेज आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन माय अर्लियर टॉक आल्सो. यू कैन, इफ यू आर अ टेकी देन इट्स ओके, इफ यू आर नॉट अ टेकी यू कैन फाइंड अ फ्रेंड हु कैन मेक अ लैंडिंग पेज. सो ड्यूरिंग अ व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप और समथिंग यू कैन सेंड अ ईमेलर. And there you can write to know more, click here, and when the person clicks that page, he goes to that landing page, and there you can also judge how much somebody is giving his eyes and ears to your idea. So again, very important part of prototyping. Video tailor, very very important. If it can be done from your side, it would be a wonderful. In the same way, whenever you have been asked to make a PowerPoint presentation, you try to make a video presentation out of it with an effective sound, effective highlights, so that you are able to judge the customers and their behavior towards your video, because it will not cost you much as compared to making a overall product and then changing your product as per consumer behavior. A and B test, I have already given you a bit of glimpse into it. It is only applied when you have different versions of the product. When I talk about different version of the product, you are adding few services at X, you are adding some Y services at different place, and then you can do A and B test. And the last in this is pop-up shops. When I talk about pop-up shops, I can give you an example that, for example, if you are into a cooking business and you make a very good idli and dosa or something like that. So what you are doing, you are not opening a shop or you are not renting a shop, putting an infrastructure or something. What you are doing for a week, you are sharing some place with somebody. Right, sharing a place with somebody, what I want to say, maybe circus sort of a setup. Ki 5 din 7 din lagaya, behavior check kiya ki haan mere market mein kaisa hua, kaisa laga, achha laga, nahi laga, consumer ne kitna price diya. Yahi pe aap price bhi check kar sakte ho ki raise the price karke, right? सो पॉपअप आपको हेल्प करता है कि आपका फिक्स कॉस्ट ना खर्च हो और आप अपने प्रोडक्ट को चेक कर पाए. सो आई होप आप समझ गए होंगे कि कैसे ये प्रोटोटाइप आपको हेल्प करेगा इन टर्म्स ऑफ not incurring a lot of cost and helping you to judge the product. So in the last part of my slides, what I have done, I have put some apps which will help you in prototyping. So though I can share these my slides with your team members and you can get from them, but few apps which help you to prototype are like POP, prototyping on paper, right? A very helpful app so that you can design on a piece of paper and then you can put it on this app, so it will become like a, it will just help you to prototype on paper. The second is InVision. Again, it is just like POP, but it will help you. So what you people can do, you can download these apps, you can go through them. Even college can, though many of them are free, but if few of them are paid also, then college can also think about that if you have a startup cell or incubation cell, then can they go up for these prototyping tools? So in the way, there is something called Webflow, which helps you to even make website, even if you don't know coding. So in the way, there is something called Origami Studio. There is something called Adobe XD, Azure RP. So these are few prototyping tools which will help you to prototype your idea before moving it into the main, before making it into the main business. So from my side, these are few informations which will help you and your students and help, you know, to give some sort of advantage to their students in terms who have started their entrepreneur journey or something. So I don't know what how the open house can be conducted, but if you people have any questions and the moderator is allowing them to ask, I'm okay with it. So am I audible? Yes.
Anybody? Yeah. Yes, sir. You are audible. So anybody wants to ask any question, may ask.
So if there is something, or even the way I have prototyped my business or the ideation stage, I can tell you my part of the journey also. So before this, if you people have any question or you want to ask something or the other. So you can dig deep into the process. What I tried to do, I tried to help you to understand about the prototyping and importance of prototyping. But if you people don't have any question or something,
maybe, sir, they will just let me know later and I shall again discuss, because the students are very I would not say minor, but still, since this topic is new to them, I suppose they may be having some queries, and I shall again let you know, sir.
Okay. So what I can do, apart from this theory aspect, what I can do in another 5-7 minutes is, I have in total, I have incubated 3 businesses as of now. So, and all my businesses have at least on the minimum tune have touched 50 to 100 crore mark, right? So if I talk to you about my journey of ideation till whatever you say, from ideation till the overall company formation, I have also done lot much of prototyping. In my current venture, where my major role is skilling youth and making them aware about the greener side of the economy. When I talk about the greener side of the economy, I start talking about triple bottom line. I start talking about save earth. I start talking about doing the business, but considering your earth in between. In the same way, how you can, for example, if you are selling plastics, you might make 500% of profit, but if that plastic is not degradable, you will be creating lot of problem to this nature. But in the same way, if you are making a plastic which is biodegradable, you are also solving the problem of not hurting the nature. So when my idea, when we ventured out with Blue Planet Environment, we came with an idea that how we can do something which is profitable also, and the same time it is giving back to the nature also. So this is for all the people who are into this startup journey or who wants to start up. This is a very well thought of idea these days. If you are making some sort of business which is considering nature also, right? Are you getting my point? When I talk about considering nature also, I gave you example of plastic. If you are able to create a water bottle which is degradable in nature, so you will make money also, and the same time you will not hurt the nature also. Because as of now, you should try to understand whatever you are throwing, it is in the earth itself. Your waste does not go to Mars or Jupiter. It is there in the earth, and it is creating lot much problem. In the same way, today, if somebody is solving the problem of batteries, because everybody wants to go for electric vehicles, if you are able to solve the problem of battery storage, you are into a big business, because in coming 2030, 2040, everybody would be talking about electric vehicles. Everybody would be talking. If you have a business idea for charge stations, right? So if you are able to think on these lines, it's not bad to think upon the regular business. It's okay. But if you are able to think both in terms of business also and in terms of greener side of the business also, believe me, investors would be putting a lot of money into you as compared to selling a product, making a product which is not environmental friendly. So though you can get buyers, but there is a high probability that big investors will not put money into your venture. So my only suggestion to you is, during your college days or during your startup journey, try to keep this point into your brain that you should keep your this point into the brain that how your business is helping the nature also, right? So it's a thought and an idea in which the more you will explore, the more you will be able to get good ideas of the business. And last, I'm open. I have my email IDs are with your college. I'm into this green sector. So anybody who wants to do any sort of discussion or any this, your college is very close to me. I love to visit your college more often whenever I get time. So whatever, if you want some validations, or if you want some sort of industry exposure, you can talk to your college and they can get connected with me. So that's it from my side, and I think whatever I was able to tell you about prototyping and validation would help you in your near future journey. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. Indeed, it was a very thought-provoking session. Thank you so much for such a lovely session.